if it is X or O or this or that. Not just if I change it and say that this is my hand and it goes like this, it come like this, it go like this. Can you tell that whether my hand is going from top to down or down bottom to up? Top to bottom, bottom to up. If I say that, can you tell me that what type of action that I am doing? You understand? And if I show you only one image, can you tell? If I show you multiple images, how can you tell? When you can see multiple images at once, you have to see multiple images at the same time when you are deciding and computing your features. You want to say that this is top to bottom. It's important information. How can you get that? Now you are seeing this image, this image, this image, this image. Five images you have seen. And your filter is able to see these five images in one time. That is why you do not have a single image. Instead of that, you are having one image and you are seeing that in time. That is actually the convolution. You have got XY of an image, basically one image, then the second, you have got a video. Frame number one, frame number two, frame number three, and in first frame, second frame, third frame, fourth frame, fifth frame, in these five frames. So now, if I apply H or 3 by 3 by 5, what does it mean? I am looking 3 by 3 image area, but of 5 frames. And I have a video which is 50 time frames, I have a video. So now you can move it in X direction, you can move in Y direction, and you can move in Z direction or the T direction. And if you can do, then you are going to get X and Y is going to give you the spatial features. And this time, this direction when you are moving, it is going to give you the temporal features. And then, if you apply in all these three directions, you are going to get spatio-temporal features. So if you wanted to do anything related to action or videos, or you want to see a video and then say that whether he is playing a cricket, playing cricket or football. So you will have to come up and make up a network. Individual images are not going to help. Then you will have to see group of images. To see group of images, your filter is going to be moving in X, Y as well as in T direction. And that is why this is actually called as the 3D convolution. 3D convolution says that I have height, I have width and I have T. So I can move in all possible directions like this. So for one such filter, you will be getting a response like this. One filter, you are going to get responses like this, which essentially mean that here if you apply your filter, you will get one value. Then you move there, then you move here, and then you move here as well. So when you move up and down, you will get one phase. And when you move in time, you will get this thing. That is why this is one filter's, first filter's response over this time. You know, over this video. And then you apply the second filter, the third filter, and for each and every filter, then you will get these responses over which you can do aggregation. They are going to have information which are going to talk about the spatio-temporal relationship. Spatial features which are related in time. Spatial features which are related in time. Yes. So just now see that you now all understand that how this 2D convolution is working. Very simple thing that now I want to talk about is about we are about to finish. So to make sure that you understand this, because probably you may be able to understand, this is my image X or image red or channel number 1, channel number 2, channel number 3. I have filter number 1, filter number 2. Filter number 1 is channel first, channel second, channel third. Filter number second, channel first, channel two, channel three. And this is the response of this input to this feature, filter, this is the response. And when I take this thing and apply this filter, this is the response. This is the detail. Now how it is being done? I take this, multiply, place it over here, take this, place it over here, take this, place it over here. This is the 2D convolution that we are going to, but our filter is 3D. Then I apply something. What you are going to get? You are going to get one single value. 27 values you got add up. This is the feature for this xy. For this xy and for this xy. This is the xy's r, g, and b value. You will multiply this and get this value and it is going to be placed over here. Then what you do? You do strike. So then you will apply it over here. Here you will be applying over here. And again you will apply over here. Same thing. Multiply, get the value. It's going to come over here. And do it for all. You will get this whole thing. Then you carry on. And then you go to the second filter. So once you do that, then you do it for the second filter. Same thing. And then you will get this thing. So if you apply, then the same things are going to be, the same thing we have seen, that you are going to get information. Now suppose that if you have 224 by 224 by 3 and some convolution, and then if I say how many, suppose that, what do you assume that what you have done over here to get something like this? How many? 64 filter. What is going to be, tell me any filter that you have applied over here. 3 by 3 by 3 filter we have applied. And how many such filters? You can apply also 5 by 5 by 3. 5 by 5 by 3 filter and make it same. So if it is 5 by 5 by 3, how much amount of padding one should have to do? 2 upper, 2 left, 2 right, 2 down, and so on. Yes, so after that I have done the pooling. You will get pooling, how many parameters to learn? How many parameters one should have to learn for pooling? No parameters to learn. Yes, pooling doesn't require any parameter to be learned. ReLU also do not require any parameter to be learned. But there is a parametric ReLU which requires one parameter to be learned, that is the alpha, the slope in the negative. This is maximum, and this is our. So we all understand. So now you see that what they have done is that, given any image, they have trained a network, and then the independent filters that are being learned in first conv layer, they have visualized. First conv layer, 3 by 3 filter you have applied, I can always see this 3 by 3 as an image, we just have elongated. Then they said that, what type of thing that you are learning over here? It's actually color blobs that you are learning. It's learning that, is there something of this color here or something of this color over here? It's learning that in center something like this. These things are especially learning low level filters. What are they? Gabor filter. We have seen filters which are very related to Gabor. And if I take these filters and apply it over image like this, this is the type of filtering which is happening. These filters are looking this image and they are being seen like this. And yes, they started to aggregate. Now you started to get independent individual components. You are not able to see this thing currently as a face. But lower filters are trying to see like this, and later on you keep on aggregating. After that you started to see, initially you see certain points, certain important edges and so on, and then you keep on aggregating. At some layers you started to see that there are eyes, there are mouth, there are nose, and again keep on aggregating. At last only you will be able to see that whether there is a face or not. And over that you started to apply your FCs, then you open and then you apply it. That okay, this is the confidence because what it my image is saying, that there is an eye, confidence that there is a nose, confidence there is an ear. Accordingly, there is face or no face, last two classes. Few of them are saying yes when it is going there, few of them are saying no when it is going there. Yes, this is done. Thank you. Yes.